Francis Crick proposed that specialized RNA molecules, known as tRNA, act as an adapter in the binding of amino acids to the corresponding mRNA sequence. Referring to the central dogma, DNA and RNA are both made of nucleotides. Therefore, transcription occurs without the need for an adapter. In order for an RNA nucleotide sequence to transit to a protein peptide sequence, ribosomes and an adapter molecule must be present. Because there are a limited number of tRNAs compared to the 61 codons that code for amino acids, some amino acids require multiple tRNAs. Based on the wobble hypothesis, a single tRNA can pair with more than one codon. Amino acyl synthase is an enzyme unique to each amino acid that recognizes the appropriate amino acid for each tRNA. Once the tRNA is bound to an amino acid, it is considered charged, thus completing the first step of translation. During the initiation phase, the small ribosomal subunit is led by its base pair, the Shine-Delgarno sequence, to position itself over the start codon of the mRNA sequence. The charged tRNA then arrives at the start codon, where the large ribosomal subunit joins with the small ribosomal subunit to integrate the mRNA and tRNA at the start codon. Three sites are present on the ribosome, the A, P, and E sites, bringing us to the elongation phase of translation. The newly charged tRNA enters the P site, where the peptide bonds between the amino acids are formed. The exposed A site is met with an additional charged tRNA molecule at the 3' end, where the 3-base sequence of the anticodon loop pairs with the complementary 3-base codon sequence in the mRNA. A peptide bond is then formed between the amino acids at the A and P sites, sending the empty tRNA molecule to the E site, where it exits to be recycled. The process continues as each amino acid from the A site is added to the polypeptide chain at the P site. This is referred to as translocation, resulting in the formation of an amino acid chain. Eventually, a stop codon arrives at the A site, signaling the termination phase of translation. In place of tRNA, release factors enter the ribosome and bind at the stop codon. The newly formed protein recognizes the stop codon and disassembles the RNA and ribosomal subunits in response. Certain medications can contribute to alterations in translation, preventing tRNA from acting as an adapter. Erythromycin, an antibiotic, can cause an inhibitor to bind at the A site, blocking the entrance of a charged tRNA molecule. This can result in bacterial cell death, allowing an infection to heal with the use of antibiotics.